It is very hard. So life is very hard. So it is not just a matter of water. If after fetching water, you can do other things. So we fetch water for about 10 minutes. After that, the rest of the day, you can do other works.
Okay, here's the deal. Yvonne says it's not just a matter of water. After fetching water, you can do other things. Let's do that. In the next 10 minutes, we shall look at opportunity. We shall have no blaming, no shaming, no claiming. No why not. Okay with you? So where are we starting from? Jessica?
Business as usual doesn't work, right? It's what we've done now for 20 years. These successes, some of them bigger than others, but we need to rethink the way we do increase access to safe water. And if you guys don't do it, nobody else will do it, so.
Revolution. How do you see it, Kariuku?
Revolution is not taking up arms and marching the streets. I think it's from our own mindset. We need to change the way we see things. We need to change how others see things.
Can we? Can we combine a revolution with realism? What does it take, Chilo?
The community alone, something sometimes is difficult, some challenge. No entrepreneurship and private alone can be also face some difficulty in terms of the relationship with the authority, local authority, and also some just have only one idea, but the community, they have more ideas, so they can share. So that's why at the end we combine these two models, community and private, together.
Can you buy into that, Alyssa?
Venture capitalists that may never have gotten involved are saying, you know, I'm ready to leverage my assets and want more than just financial returns. I want to look at the social and environmental impact as a double or triple bottom line investment.
But will the consumer buy it? Jackie?
When you purchase something, when you're living on less than $4 a day, when you make a choice and you purchase something to improve your life, you have more of a tendency to invest your time in, more of a tendency to take care of it.
So roll on the design revolution. Now, how can we design a revolution on the go? What kind of journey is it? Wanjugu?
It's been a journey. It's been a very interesting journey. Especially being a family business that has come from a very informal sector to small enterprise.
The thing is, all these practitioners are heading the same way, but down different paths at different speeds. That's business as usual. It's not going to work. The revolution comes in connecting success and synergy. There will be barriers and roadblocks to remove, accidents to learn from. But in a decade, and in a word, there will be scale up. Accidents do happen. In August 2012, just 2 hours after the official opening of the Tuksat Clean Water Plant No. 59 in eastern Cambodia, the delivery plans literally slipped down into a ditch. It was solved, but it was avoidable. That accident is a true story. It happened to some of the greatest water professionals you could ever meet. It could, it will, it should happen to all of us. Somewhere along the road to the delivery of safe water. The obstacle, we are told, is about affordability. Will people pay for safe water? Many poor people do buy mobile phones and televisions. It's all relative.
Simply the fact that it is technically possible to do something doesn't mean it's affordable, accessible, in demand, would be adopted, would be effective in the real world.
Water is not hot. It's not aspirational, not a matter of desire. So the poor sometimes show little willingness to pay, and other times they show massive desire. Instead of designing a should have, we should go for a want to have. Try that.
La salud y con el agua filtrada tenemos salud. Estamos muy agradecidos porque hemos tenido, pues ya tenemos el filtro para tomar el agua de salud, el agua filtrada, porque sabemos que es fuente de salud el agua filtrada.
Profitability. The sustainable delivery of safe water service demands a business-like approach. The bottom line is a human right, to be sure, but it must be paid for. It needs entrepreneurs with enterprise.
Kim LaPaglia, and I would classify myself as a social entrepreneur, which I define, yes, absolutely, social entrepreneur, define as not someone who gives someone a fish or teaches to fish, but changes the fishing industry. Why not take on a big challenge?
But how many local business people stay clear of it, not seeing a clear path to a decent profit? Too many, and their advisors do not help.
One of the reasons that we believe very strongly in market-based solutions, in treating the poor as customers, is that that levels the playing field. You're now equals. My job is to give you what you desire, not to tell you what you ought to take.
So how about we change the mindset of support agencies and thus their training curricula? It's a long-term approach, but we start now. Market, market. It's the same old market again. You know, market forces are not a goal. They're not to be idolized or idealized, but just applied. They do need, though, to breathe and not to choke.
I feel that if you are being subsidized heavily, then you run the risk, of achieving something on a temporary basis, and not on the long run.
Often free gifts stop or slow down the emergence of a viable market. The best of intentions in this case have the worst of results.
Water has always been either subsidized by God, it comes down from the sky for free.
How about if we have a code of conduct to restrict donated devices to being demonstration tools? And what if we smarten up subsidies and grants to build up the supply chain?
Thank you.
demand. The needs are known, at least they're recognized from outside. So are the gains. But where is the demand? Are we expecting a demand that will not come? Does social marketing itself demand too much of the consumer?
You always need a joint intervention of a public sector that takes the responsibility for educating people and raising awareness. Basically, I mean, one could call it a subsidized demand creation at the community level.
How can we reshape social marketing to understand how behavior can change in an unhelpful context? Is the dilemma about preach or reach? Do we come back to the issue of desire?
Historia toda la, nos arroja datos de que, bueno, si estamos ahorita, todo lo que se habla calentamiento global tiene un impacto hasta ahora porque eso viene desde atrás. Entonces, si nosotros primero tenemos que conocer la historia, ¿verdad? Para saber cómo poder actuar ahora.
Another dilemma is the rule of law.
So what we're trying to determine is what factors need to be in place and to what extent do those factors need to be in place for the success of household water treatment and safe storage, and also what factors are generally in place in some communities that limit the success of adopting HWTS projects.
Some laws and standards designed to ensure the purest water possible do not reward or encourage upcoming methods of water treatment. Sometimes, more laws could stimulate the safe water sector. Lower tariffs, fiscal preferences, national policies, inclusive standards. What incentives will motivate legislators to act for safe water? Some practitioners cling to the belief that money is short for safe water. Maybe it's not. Maybe that's a myth. Maybe the money is missing the point. Maybe potential investors do not see the gains of financial partnerships around safe water. And maybe the safe water communities do not see how to best access and apply unused finance.
In the developing world, I think there's a number of impact investors, and again, I think that's one of the mindset shifts that needs to be taking place, and that we apply our models of philanthropy or our models of investing, where there are different models that are applied on, in different geographical contexts.
It's a case of explaining each opportunity to the other, explaining how safe water is a personal and a global game changer, and how innovative finance can work for water. Carbon finance is an example. It's an enticing but very complex stream of revenue. It needs explaining before use. It's been quite a journey so far. There will be more bumps and blocks on the way. Quality control, record keeping, our own behavior changes, and more. But it will be a very interesting journey, best taken together. A journey of delivery, a journey of scale up.
It's been a very interesting journey, especially because we've been impacting lives.